Hey, everyone. All right, so I'm going to explain your assignment for this week. And we're going to be continuing to look at sampling. So the main site we're going to use is called whosampled.com. So here's the homepage. They also have a phone app, but I think it costs $1 or $2. So you can just use the site without, you can just use the site on a browser. You don't need to use the app. But anyway, whosampled.com. One thing that's fun that I always do with classes when we're in person is we'll play this six-degree game. And we did a little bit of this in class, but basically it's just fun. You can go try it out. But basically you can type in any two artists. And I'm going to start with, well, between two hip-hop artists, it's almost too easy because everyone's worked with everybody and everybody sampled everybody. So you got to go like outside of hip-hop to make it work. So I'm going to do Frank Sinatra and Playboi Carti and see if they're connected. They are. I'll give you a hint. So most artists, there's not even 2 degrees. And this one's almost too easy. That's the thing with hip hop and sampling, is everyone sampled everything. So Frank Sinatra, Nancy Wilson covered Frank Sinatra. There's a Playboi Carti song that samples Nancy Wilson. Let's do one more. Let's do Stevie Wonder. And what's something? Who's someone more obscure? Well, not exactly obscure, but more out of genre. Or I was gonna do Daddy Yankee, but let's try Bad Bunny. There we go. Stevie Wonder and Bad Bunny. Still just 2 degrees. Sampled by Tori. I don't know who this is. I've never heard of this person. But apparently they've worked together directly. And this person sampled Stevie Wonder. Let's try to get three. Let's just do one more. Let's do the Beatles. And Nav. Come on, I hope this works. Nope. James Brown covered the Beatles. Nav sampled James Brown. Or a Nav song. Funny. All right, so that's kind of fun. Have fun with that. But the way to use the site in general is basically you type in any song and it'll tell you what it sampled. So I'm just going to do Champion by Kanye. And they're going to have the original song up there. But then where did the sample come from? So this is the, did you realize that you were a champion in their eyes? And this obviously goes through the whole song on Kanye's track. And so it'll play this. On here, and it'll jump right to where that sample comes from.
Did you realize that you were a champion in their eyes?
Yeah, and there it is. The song goes on. And we've never heard that part because he didn't sample that part. He just used that one little snippet. So that's what you can do. It's kind of cool to go here, hear where all this stuff came from. You've seen me use this site even in the first couple of weeks going through history stuff. I pulled up this site to show you who sampled who. But this is the point where I want you to try this out on your own. So what I'm going to send to you is, did I lose my tab? Here we go. Okay. What I'm going to send to you is this site. I'm going to send you a Google Slides thing. And what I've made it, or how I've made it, is that you can actually edit. This used to be a worksheet that I would print out, but I heard, oops, let's do this again and back to here. Basically some teachers shared this where you can do this. So I've turned each of these into little text box that you can just type into. So with this, so what we just did, I would type in Champion by Kanye is the hip hop track. And then the track that was sampled was Kid Charlemagne by, did I spell Charlemagne right? I don't know. By Steely Dan. And what was used, now on the site, it's going to say, what does it say? It just says multiple elements. So that doesn't tell you much. But if you listen to it, then you can hear. So it's like voice, drums, guitars, etc. Now, some of them, it's not all that stuff. It's just one or two things. Why did this just close again? I don't know what's going on here. But so then I could type in those things as in terms of what was used and so on. The bottom of this. Come on. There we go. Oh, hold on. Something's going on with my browser. No. Let's try this again. Okay, something weird is happening. That's okay. All right, the bottom of this is basically the opposite. So start with a non-hip hop artist. So I just threw out some random ones, but any non-hip hop artist, and then see if there was some hip hop that sampled it. And so as an example, now Lauryn Hill is a hip hop artist, but Lauryn Hill X Factor was sampled for Drake's God's Plan. Was it God's Plan? I think so. The care for me, just to be there for me, that one. So I would type in X Factor, Lauryn Hill, Drake, God's Plan, and then what was sampled, her vocals and lyrics. And if they did something to it, so like in that case, whoever did the producing for that, was it the, I don't know who it was for that one. But whoever did that, you could say that one was sped up for sure, which also was pitched up. So it didn't just sound like Lauryn Hill's original track. It was a little bit different. So that's how you would do that. I'm also going to post this link, which is kind of cool. This is just for fun. But basically, someone put this together where they went and chopped up the record that they sampled. So like for this Kanye track, Otis, that many of you have heard, they sampled an Otis Redding track. So if you go through this, you can hear all these chops, and then at a certain point you can so you can recreate that, and it'll show you right here what the samples that were used. So here's a Ninth Wonder one, and so you can just use your keyboard, or if you're on a mobile device, you can just click on it directly to kind of replay these samples. So this is a really cool thing to check out. All right, that's it. Hopefully that explains everything with this assignment, and this is going to be due on Friday. Thanks for doing a great job with the J. Dilla assignment, and I'll catch you later. Have a good one. Oh, wait, hold on. Let me say goodbye to you in person. Ready? See you later. Have a good one, everybody.